here again is Lindley on the end around. Back to throw that ball. That ball's toward the far side in the corner and caught at the 1 yard line. What play calling? Preston King is the one who makes the reception on the far side, but Austin Amolo is the one who throws the ball. For heaven's sakes, last week it was Devon Brown to Vincent Brown. This time now it's tight end throwing the ball for 24 yards.
So, yeah, it was not a dull game. Like Coach said, he was embarrassed by some things and disappointed by others. But offensively, I don't think Aztec fans are upset at all. Not at all. And had the end around, actually the running back halfback option pass with Devon Brown to Vincent Brown. And now you got Amolo throwing the ball.
Right.
Al, I think from what I've seen creatively, has a pattern and a rhythm that really I believe will give defenses a lot to think about.
Well, I think it does. You know, just by personnel and formations that he uses, it's always difficult to defend. But I think now I think we know kind of where we're at as a team. I think we know that we've got to be a little more creative at times. And when you do that, you can get some big plays, and it's been positive.
And you ran some Wildcat. You're a Wildcat right. fan? The great quote by Troy Aikman the other day, that he said, Wildcat's like Twitter. You know, everybody's doing it, but they don't know why.
Right.
So they just do it. But the Dolphins, I thought the Dolphins beat the Chargers with that last year. That's how good it can be. And you're starting to use that a little bit.
Well, you know, you got to look at your personnel. It always comes down to your personnel and putting guys in position to make plays. And with Preston King, young freshman, wide receiver, running back, we've kind of used him all over, and now a little bit as a quarterback in there in the Wildcat, and being able to have Vince come across and getting the ball to your playmaker on some of the jet sweeps. And then this was just another segment of kind of the Wildcat with the throwback mm-hmm. when Lindley was under center.
Oh, he was good. It was good. The first time I saw Lindley go out, flanked out to the far side of the first few plays, I thought, is it my eyes? No. The quarterback's out there, and it really, I think, really worked well and puts pressure on the defense. I thought last year that Davion Maldon was one of the best athletes that the freshman class provided, and I really thought you missed him. Having him back in the secondary and returning kicks, I think you're a better football club.
Well, I think it helps. I think, you know, his maturity, his experience, and you know, the real positive for us was our kickoff returns. We averaged right at 27 yards a return, and if you can do that, and that saves the offense getting 2.5 first downs, that's a big plus. And I thought the guys did a good job with the scheme that we employed, and you know, I thought Davion did a nice job.
Brady, take us to Colorado State, which you're going to do this later in the week, but in terms of this club, they're hard to get a read on. They start out hot and then win several, and then they lose several.
Well, you know, they're 3-4, and they've lost 4 in a row. They've played BYU, TCU, and Utah.
Mm-hmm.
Had a chance to beat Utah. And, you know, last week it was a good game for a while down at TCU, and then it kind of just got out of hand. They're a physical football team. They run the ball very well. The quarterback, who is an older guy who hadn't played much, has done a really good job of directing them when you look at touchdowns to interceptions and managing the game. And they're a team that's a very good football team. Just, you know, they played what people consider the top three teams in this league. And, you know, those three teams are pretty good.
This is the first time, although Idaho had a little of it, altitude. You're a big altitude guy in terms of before I get the question that I know Brady enough now, he's going, altitude, come on.
No, you know, our kids, the way we condition and the way we practice, you know, it's not a factor. I think that, Ted, becomes really a lot, and people talk about enough, and guys start believing it. So I don't put much stock into it.
Brady, always good talking football with you, man. Good luck at Colorado State.
Thanks, Ted.
Very winnable game, no question about that. These are the teams that are on the level of San Diego State, Wyoming's and the UNLVs and so forth, and this Colorado State team. We mentioned Beth Burns and Aztec women's basketball. I do want to let you know and let you see that the game will be 1 o'clock Pacific time on Saturday. It is on the Mountain Network. It is locally on Channel 4 in San Diego, and it is on with the broadcast that I am involved in, thank goodness, on AM 600 KOGO. May it always be so. Back with more on Aztecs Now in a moment.